this concert despite of this not very pleasant weather. We appreciate you being here. Okay, I am excited to organize this concert as part of UNG's A Little Night Hawk concert series in conjunction of celebration of International Women's Day. International Women's Day is a global celebration that happens annually, and it's actually supposed to be celebrated tomorrow, so we're 1 day ahead. Echo UNG would be wrong, right? And this year's theme is Break the Bias. So I am extremely proud to present this evening's concert. You will be hearing various styles of music from typical Western European art to Appalachian folk songs on various type of musical instruments from piano, violin, all the way to fiddle and banjo. So you're in for a treat for sure. So in today's world with the COVID and everything, it is full of uncertainty, fear, war, and scarcity. The women of UNG Music Department stands together. We share our talents with you, and we support and encourage and empower each other. Thank you very much. We are about to start. A few reminders I would like to bring your attention to. First, please silence your phone. We do not want any unexpected musical elements being added to the program. So if you will please take this moment right now and silence your phone. But I would appreciate it. There's a slight program change, second to the last on the program. Dr. Sang-hee Lee's piano solo performance. There has been an era. She will be performing Chopin, Frederick Chopin's Ballade, not number one, but number four in F minor, opus 52. Without further ado, we'll get started. Thank you.
Thank you. colleague of mine, there's on Telegram, so we play together, we work together. And she's also a very incredible composer, and she wrote this piece for violin and piano. And attached to, connected to this piece, there is a poem that I would like to read you as kind of an introduction that will lead to the piece. A caged bird dreams on freedom. Quiet submission turns into hope. Hope turns into power. It bursts through the door and sings its song of freedom, drawing the sound of brass against brass as the empty cage rings, and then the bird is gone. I open the door.
Thank you. program that we do here in the fall, and several of us just fell in love with her music. We loved it so much that we actually had her in residence last month for a couple of days and did two back-to-back concerts of her music. These three trios were featured on there, and she writes beautifully in so many different styles. The first one is more classical in nature, based on a Chopin-esque type of idea. The second one is more just a love song. And the third one is a tango. So enjoy all of that.
Thank you. Wandering alone in a churchyard, the mourner finds some consolation upon hearing the church choir singing Psalm 121. I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills.
Thank you. Thank you. played on a fiddle and banjo duet, which long predates the string band with like guitar and bass and mandolin and all that stuff. So the fiddle and banjo duet in fact dates to enslaved Africans in the 1770s, so first record of this pairing, which has persisted ever since. So this is the kind of music that you would have heard at a Saturday night dance in the late 19th century, maybe. Probably not played by girls, but I'll get to that a little bit later. So that's an old tune, dates at least to the 1740s, Arkansas Traveler. This next one, Soldier's Joy, is even older. Records brought her and her friend Eva Davis up to New York City for 2 days to record two dance moves while she's playing, which is really cute.
Thank you.
Women Power.